let's restructure or break Nigeria. It is the breakup of the country, that's all. I have said it severally. Either you restructure the country to federalism, where everybody is an equal partner, or it will be to thy tents, O Israel, whereby the country fragments and everyone goes his way to mind his or her own business. Who we accept to be an underdog, and that is why Buhari has refused to do anything to change this constitution. I've been telling him, if you are honest, change this constitution, which was made without the consent of the people. You loaded everything against the South and you want it to continue. When you came in as military ruler, you made your laws, and later your people made a constitution and changed all the things that our founding fathers agreed to before independence. I have said it. If that is difficult for you, let's sit and agree on how to move forward, because we can't continue on the condition you impose on us. It is the hypocrite press men and hypocrite Yoruba who pretend not to know what is happening. The North knows what they are doing. All the times we have been saying we don't want this constitution because it is oppressive and one-sided. It is not a strong statement for the president to come and disabuse our minds. But he is not bothered. I am a full advocate of restructuring, and I don't want secession. I want cooperation, and the president hasn't invited those of us talking about restructuring to hear what we are talking about. If he claims he doesn't understand what it means but wants to continuously force the constitution on us because all the paraphernalia of security is in his hands under the constitution, the Fulani controls the army, navy, air force, police, DSS, customs, immigration, because the constitution is in his hands. It will not work if he lies. Let him kill everybody in the South. It can't succeed. The president wants to disunite and dislocate Nigeria by still allowing this constitution that is contrary to the agreements reached by the founding fathers for everybody to live together. This time that the northern governors were meeting all their traditional rulers were there. This is how they are ganging up, and I refer you to what Ago Abdullahi said in 2014 before the election, that it is their turn, and when we have it for keeps. I published it, and he did not deny it. Buhari is only acting a script agreed by the minority Fulani who are ruling the country and those of us who are opposing it. They say we want to secede. That is badadash. Well, I have said it, I am saying it again, that Buhari is the number one enemy of Nigeria for refusing to restructure the country, and he is the one encouraging the Nnamdi Kanus, the Sunday Igbohos, okay? Well, I am not blabbing. The Fulanis are the same whether in APC or PDP. The game they are playing now is to divide others and tell you they are for you, but in the end they will vote another northern. Can you imagine PDP of all parties zoning the president to the north? They agreed on rotation principle for equity and fair play. Then behind the scene, the APC will say, okay, we are zoning to the south, and they will vote for the Fulani candidate. Well, yes, if they are stupid enough, I am saying it's allowed and clear. They should resist it and say no. What is the ground of the PDP saying they are zoning the president to the north? They are not doing policies of principle, no ideology behind it, just self-serving. Even the Igbo that I am defending are not helping matters. When the APC said they were going to support Tinubu, they were deceiving him. Now, to cover their deceit, they said they were going to zone it to the south and they are giving it to Tinubu, but the same party is encouraging Fayemi, encouraging Amosu and encouraging the vice president, and they are talking of Goodluck Jonathan to go and repeat in order to divide the south. It is all lies. They have divided the southeast, assuring them also that they were going to be the president, especially those dragging their feet over restructuring. It is all lies. I told you people not to vote for Buhari in 2015 and you refuse. Where are we now? All I am saying is that if the Northern insist and succeeds in their plan for 2023, it will lead to everybody going back to his tent. The British amalgamated us without consulting us, so we will go our separate ways without consulting anyone. They joined the East and the West because they couldn't maintain the North because of their poverty, and we agreed at independence on certain grounds and conditions. But today, the North has deviated from that, and that is why we are in trouble. The problem we are having now is the constitution drawn up by them, and they allocated everything to themselves, and they want the South to continue to follow them. I repeat, we either restructure the country or break the country. Even though the British didn't consult us before joining us, it is not their fault that the Fulani breached the terms of agreement of living together. We agreed at Lancaster House on the constitution before independence, which was handed over to us. It is the ability to dominate by a section of the ethnic groups because they control the military and security that is causing the problem. We don't have a problem with the British thought. They are encouraging them and their collaborators in the South. Well, Commando Olahomi Olakunle has told the nation that Buhari wanted to Islamize Nigeria. Didn't you read it or listen or watch the video clip? Have they come out to refute it? I challenge Gabriel Shehu, Femi Adesina and Lai Mohammed to refute what the man said. They must have listened to it. Nobody would say half of what the man said without them attacking or defuting. Well, they sent the report to the president. Commander Olahomi said some of those they accused of are now governors, senators, and in Aso Rock. What is the reply of the government? The man was on air saying it. Has the presidency replied? When it was reported that DSS has arrested him, they say they didn't arrest him but were merely asking him questions. What has happened thereafter? Did DNOs arrest him because they know he was speaking the truth? It is the press that refused to pick it up from there. Even media commentators refused to say anything thereafter, because there is an executive order to close down any unfriendly media house. Before, people don't want to talk before they don't want to die. But Ayo Adebanjo will want to talk and speak the truth because he wants to die and go to heaven. That is why I am saying what I am saying. Well, he has said it all already. So if you people like those who knows the truth should continue keeping mute, and those who doesn't know and doesn't want to know should continue. Time shall tell. Everybody will reap what he or she sows. Well, you can go to the comment section and share your take and your own opinion on this article. Thanks for listening.